Aahana Kumra, I'm just so happy always. The size of my smile says how happy I am when I speak to you. How are you doing?
I've been great. I've been fantastic. I've kept my food goodies right next to me. Eating and happy.
Yeah, I mean, working girl has got to eat, right? You have to get the fuel going. I ran through 8 episodes and I am absolutely in love with this show.
You watched it?
Yes, I did. I mean, few of our senior journalists get a preview copy. And of course, you know, this is releasing on after the official release on Sony Live, so we can talk about it. And it's not a whodunit, which is a spoiler and things like that. But, you know, it really took me back to, as a 90s kid, growing up on Friends and the Big Bang Theory and Seinfeld, man. And a prime example of taking that sitcom concept and making it so Indian, so desi. And that must have appealed to you at the get-go, the whole premise of it.
Yeah, I think that was like the complete this thing. When they told me it's a show about a couple that is sandwiched between, you know, both the in-laws, the respective in-laws, I was like, this is a no-brainer. This is 100% something that I want to do. Also, when I got a call for it, they told me that the shoot days are only 15 and the rehearsal days are 30, which I think was like, I'm doing it. It's like a play. So my managers didn't understand. And I was like, dekho, jab natak hota hai na, to 3 mahine ki rehearsal hoti hai. Phir ek din ka show hota hai. Uske liye 3 mahine rehearsals karni padti hai. So, I mean, you know, honestly, the whole format was just like doing 15 mini plays. And honestly, like the OTT is a really grim place. You know, they don't really have too much, there isn't too much humor on the OTT. It's usually crime dramas or love stories or other things, you know. But like the element of humor has been missing for a very long time. And I think, you know, I was like, okay, now this is it. You know, we have to do this. Again, another thing was that I was never offered a comedy. And this is the first time I was doing something, you know, in the comic space on the OTT. A televised version of it, because I've done it on stage, but I've never really done it in the OTT. So I was like, yes, I'm doing it. Yes. So yeah.
I was just completely enthralled to see this whole situation. I mean, it's just a super premise, isn't it? Kunal Roy Kapoor and myself were just having a laugh about this, saying guys like him and me, like Kunal and Hrishi K, with all due respect to our lovely wives, when a hot girl, you know, a leggy Aahana Kumra comes into their lives, that's the beginning of a great story. So he's like, bro, you hit the nail on the head. That is a great story. Because if Aahana Kumra had been with a hot guy with his washboard abs, it wouldn't have made for a great story. So I think there is that beauty in couples, you know, one being a slacker, the other being a fitness freak, one being a slightly high energy, the other being, you know, and we see that all around us, isn't it? I'm sure you've seen enough couples like that. So talk about the premise and the fact that relationships like that are very successful ones.
Okay, my brother-in-law is going to kill me for this, but it's exactly the story like how my brother-in-law, my sister is. You know, she's like this fitness freak and my brother-in-law is like this Bengali man, you know, not as enthused as my sister. He's like, yeah, I'm going to take it easy. You girls do what you all want to do. Never interferes between the Kumra sisters, you know. So it's just one of those things. So it was really like close to home. My father is a lot like VK, you know, he doesn't let go of his daughters. So even though like my sister is married and she's, you know, she's living her life and in her own home, but I still feel like my father has that whole thing like, oh, but you know, Shivani, you can do this. Oh, you know, but you know, I'm not interfering, but I think I can suggest. So I see that happening in my house. So this is such a like, you know, funny story. And also with like mother-in-laws, like, because I've seen my friends and their mother-in-laws and how, you know, they obsess over their sons and how they are like, you know, mira beta, you know, it's one of those things. So it's just something that we see every day around us in our houses, in our friends' houses. And I think because every story also has like really simple episodes, you know, it's about, you know, like one episode is about suit Sherwani, which I think is like, you know, it's like, should he wear a suit? Should he wear a sherwani? You know, mother wants this, wife wants this. Khana kaisa banega ghar mein? I think these are just really simple things, you know, simple stories in everybody's houses. These are simple incidents. But if you can make an episode around it, I think it's quite cool. Also, I think like in comedy, especially when you see like any of these friends and all, you'll always remember, you don't really remember the episodes, but you always remember the characters. Like, I always remember like how's Rachel, and I remember what is Ross like, and I remember like how's Phoebe, because that Friends happens to be one of my favorite sitcoms, you know. And Rohan, before we started shooting this, he was like, just watch whichever sitcom you like, watch Seinfeld, watch Friends if you want to. See the way the actors hold a reaction, see the way you know, the process that an actor follows when they're doing a sitcom. So I think that was really helpful. And I was like, yeah, but I remember them by their characters. And even in this, you'll remember Kunal by the way he is. You know, he's like this lazy guy. So he's got those kind of nuances in it. I'm like this super achiever, over aggressive, over everything, you know, this sort of a person. Very competitive. And, you know, like Divya on the other hand is very like nosy. She wants to know what her son is doing, how her son is being treated in his other house. And my father is being played by Atul, somebody you would have never imagined, you know. Another fantastic casting, because I think what Atul brought to the show was absolutely, you know, really lovely, because I would have never imagined Atul Kulkarni playing a comic role. And he's brought so many nuances of, you know, that raw agent in the show. And I think he really does a fantastic job of being that, you know, like his gadgets are there, how he, you know, does his detective giri with, you know, with Kunal. I think it's quite cool with Zakir, like he's, you know, he's so endearing, because he and his plants are like his best friends, you know. I just think it's so cute. And Lubna with all her tantric antics, you know, antics, she's just like, you know, in her own world. So I just think like every character is so nicely etched out in the show, that for us it was all about playing on these characters and playing on these stories.
You know, you see, you give characters a quirk, Kahana, and often in popular contemporary cinema in India, they become caricatures,
yeah.
And there's a lot of hamming, you know. If you make a character, you know, who's into crystal balls and gazing and palmistry, the performer tends to overplay it. If you look at a quirk like talking to plants, which is a very common quirk, yeah, a lot of senior citizens talk to, you know. But the fact that all of you have just played it so naturally. Divya, I was just telling Divya, it's a scene. All her life, she's seen Saas Bahu serials where there is mourning. And she wants to be part of the Saas Bahu serial. So she's sitting with a white sari. But nowhere do you feel that, you know, there's overplay or hamming. I want to come to one very important thing about the relationships, which is so beautiful, you know. Like you said, nothing really happens in Seinfeld and Friends. You know, you don't remember the story, but you remember all these characters. So in Divya and Zakir's case, Divya clearly feels she married beneath her class, you know, and she makes it a point to keep talking about it. Whereas in your relationship with Kunal's character, you know, he thinks the sun rises and sets between his legs, you know, his ass. So he's like, you're lucky to get me. And she also says, you know, she never for a moment says, I could have got somebody, whatever, maybe in jest. But so I think that's quite interesting, yeah, that the modern couple really accept each other for what they are. And I don't think ever question saying, okay, my standard, lower standard, this, that. So in that aspect, the relationships must be so well written when you first read the script. So talk to me about the writers, the creative team, and Rohan.
So when I got the show, I remember, first of all, it was really exciting that they were offering me a comedy. And when they told me that, you know, there'll be so many rehearsal dates, I didn't understand. Like, I was like, okay, because honestly, I was also new to the format. And I was like, what are they doing? Are they making a play? I'm a little confused. Like, what is it that they are trying to achieve out here? And then when I got to set, I realized that this is the reason why. Because comedy, honestly, why don't we attempt enough comedy? Can you like actually count on your fingertips how many comedy shows have we had? What we've had, Dekh Bhai Dekh, Sara Bhai versus Sara Bhai. We've had, you know, Khichdi. We've had Tarak Mehta. I'm just saying
that... Tutu Mehme, yeah.
Tutu Mehme, hum paanch. But there haven't been... You can remember these shows because these are the only shows that we've had. There's hardly any, you know, too many of them. So that's how you can remember them. And you can literally count them on your fingertips. And I realized this in hindsight because it's really difficult to write comedy. It is so difficult to attempt it. It is a writer's medium. And 50% of your job is done if the writing of a show or a writing of a series is well done. In the same way, when they came to me, their 15 episodes were locked. And all they had was this is the character, that's the character. Is episode mein ye ho raha, is episode mein ye ho raha, is episode mein ye ho raha. And I was just like, my God, like these guys know exactly what they want and how they want to achieve it. In fact, the reason why they asked us to watch sitcoms was because they were going to shoot it like that format. And abroad, when a sitcom is shot, you know, usually what they do is they do a couple of days of rehearsal. There's a live audience that comes in and then they shoot, all the episodes, basically all the scenes of an entire episode in order of, in order of the story so that the audiences can watch it and give real reactions. In our case, because this was the first show that was going to be shot post-COVID, it was shot in August. And we were following COVID protocols. There wasn't anybody else apart from the crew, the immediate crew allowed on set and the cast. So, the only people who could be laughing on our dialogues were like we had one AD and two creatives. There were three people who were just supposed to sit and laugh. So we were always telling them, guys, please laugh. Because sometimes even they would be watching continuity or something, you know, and they would forget to laugh. And we'd be like, we cannot play to the gallery. We cannot play. Because even on a stage, when you're doing a comedy show, you're just playing to the gallery. You know how to stretch a joke. You know when to stop. You know when to move on to the next thing. But you like to play to the gallery. Here, we were getting no reactions. And it was so difficult for us to hold on to, a joke or stretch a joke or hold on to a reaction because we were like, okay, we know for sure that there's going to be a laugh here. So those kind of things. But having said that, I think the relationships that they worked out were so nicely done because we always knew that Divya is going to be, because in the writing itself, it was clear that Divya is like this, upper class family ki bandi married to this scientist, So that was very clear. In this, when Kunal and I were told about our relationship, they were like, you guys are battling your families, but your relationship is of equality. You both are equal workers. In fact, there is an episode in which Kunal does say to me that your badminton is not going to pay the bills. My computer gaming does.
You're right. Yeah.
And, and that is the only time in the entire series that he pokes, at her about her income.
Because he says stipend. What you earn is a stipend.
What you earn is a stipend, And I was just like, and Nena's character is like she can't, there's no comeback because it's true. It's his gaming and everything that pays the EMI of the house, So I think it's very nicely done, in terms of the modern relationship, how she's not poking fun about his appearance, how he's not really, saying anything to her. He's in fact very happy about the fact that he's married to somebody like her. So I just think like it's such a modern day couple where, people are not about ki tum idhar ke ho, tum udhar ke ho. That must happen. But I just think like in this case, the relationship was very, very correctly edged out. And, it got us the opportunity to play on other things and not dwell into like the smaller, these kind of things, I don't know. I just feel like this is not something like a modern couple really discusses.
Yeah, this is very beautifully explained. I don't think we give our parents enough credit or how we were brought up enough credit. You do, because, you constantly talk about your wonderful mom, your dad, your sister. But one of the reasons why I feel you're so successful, apart from being a wonderful actress, is how malleable you are as a human being. I mean, here are you. You could be working with a guy who's very South Bombay, like Rohan Sippy and Kunal. And at the other end of the spectrum, you go and you work with a half Kanpuriya director like Shahid Ali, and you seem equally comfortable, you seem equally comfortable in both worlds. And I think that's the way you've been brought up. And that's the way, your family is. And you think I'm true. Is that a good assessment of what I've made? And you do realize that it's a very important aspect to be an actor, They don't teach you that in acting school, do they?
Not really, but yes, thank you. First of all, I take that as a compliment. But you know, honestly, I also have to say that maybe I've just been really blessed with very nice people around me. I've always been nurtured. Like Shah, this is somebody who he really loves you. He really nurtures you. And I've managed to make very good friends out of, you know, Rohan and Shah and you know, Kunal. These are really loving people. They want you to excel. And I think it's very important to be able to work with people who want you to do well. And I've always said you can't make films alone. You can only make it like when you have a team together. But I think most of my learning, you know, of course, because my mom is from, you know, an industry which, you know, she's from the police department. I saw my upbringing was not a normal one. You know, I literally like the Kotwali was my playground, and you know, I saw a lot of heinous criminals. You know, when I was a child, my mother never really packed my tiffin. You know, there were cooks who were doing it. I was brought up by nannies because my mother was doing a full-time job. My father used to live in Russia and he was working for Lupin Laboratories in Russia. So, you know, he was away most times. So I think like our upbringing was very independent. Like my mother really made us very independent, and we were never told ki you can't be friends with this one or that one. And I just think like for me, I'll give a huge amount of credit to theater. I swear if I had not done theater, I would have not been able to meet the people from different stratas of society. Because, you know, honestly, when you go to school, you're meeting the same kind of kids. You know, when you go to college, honestly, college also, I think in Bombay kind of teaches you a lot, because there are people coming from every strata of society, and every, you know, somebody might be living in South Bombay, but you can also be friends with somebody who lives in Virar. So I think like that really teaches you a lot. When you do theater, you're meeting literally everybody. You're meeting everybody pan India. So, you know, there could be somebody from Bhopal, there could be somebody from the Northeast, somebody from you know, I've done theater from like with almost everybody from every part of India. And the only people who I used to really make fun of were South Indians, and now some of my closest friends are those, so I can't even make fun there. So you
Don't
know,
you even begin.
not with you also. So you know, I just think like it's very important to just be yourself, and I think that's what I try to be. I just be myself most times, and all those who can handle me are fine. Those who don't, leave anyway. So I think that kind of works. I don't want to change myself, alter myself according to how people are. I think it's important to just be who you are. And I've always been like this happy, very over the top, whatever I want to say, speak my mind sort of a person. And I think that's kind of worked for me
Yeah, I mean, you're just a fundamentally happy person, and you make others happy even through an online stream. I've got to say that one of my most abiding happy memories of this lockdown is seeing a picture of you outside Prithvi Theatre, and I could see the radiance, the joy just popping out of that photograph, you know. And I saw that picture and I said, this girl is in her happy place. You know, she can travel the world, go to foreign locations, do, you know, films with A-listers, but her heart is still in the theater. That must have been a vital, it was almost as though a moment had turned in the pandemic. You know, eventually now you've gone on sets and you started shooting, but I'm just saying, going back to Prithvi and just taking a picture there and meeting your friend.
Yeah, I met Tiwari ji, in fact. It was really funny. You know, he was just sitting there, and it was really nice to chat with him because he's really one of the oldest members of the Prithvi Theatre. And Prithvi is a happy place for all of us. I think most of us have grown up there. Most of us, I owe my career to Prithvi, because honestly, that's the first place I realized that this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. You know, I remember shooting with Lilith right now. I was shooting with Lilith about a week ago. And the first backstage work that I ever did in my life was handed a doll on in a play called 30 Days in September, which is Lilith's play. And you know, I was sitting with Shad and Lilith, and I was just like, I suddenly remembered, I was like, hey, I handed a doll in your play. That was my first backstage job. I must have been 14. She just looked at me, she's like, oh. I said, yeah. And then Shad like, please don't cry. I said, I'm not gonna cry. I just remembered it, you know. And I just wanted to tell Lilith that. It's so stupid that I didn't think about it. And I'd been shooting with her like all those days, you know. I just didn't remember it. And you know, there's so many happy memories of Prithvi, whether you know it's Lalit or whether it's Ayaz, whether it's Kunal, Sanjana. I guess like these people really like facilitated my, you know, I was a fixture there. I would not leave, you know. I would probably like, I would, you know, I could clean floors, I could do whatever, sell tickets. I just did everything at Prithvi that made me really happy. But it was time to move on, and it was time to start, you know, fending for yourself and starting to earn and, like, you know, move and do films and everything, because that would also mean, like, you know, us becoming bigger names and that pulling into the theaters and letting people come and watch our plays. So I don't think you can take Prithvi away from any of the you know, performers who have been there. In fact, I remember Naseer sir, he messaged me the day Einstein opened again in Prithvi after the pandemic, and he was like, I'm going back home. And I was in the middle of a shoot at that time. And I was like, I can feel you right now. Like, I could just hear his words resonate. And I went and watched his show. He was so happy. He was like, Aahana, I went and did 3 run-throughs. And then I could not sleep. And then I did the show. And then I could not sleep till 4 o'clock. I was so happy to be on stage. So I just think, like, it's not me alone, but it's like, I think all of us, you know, this whole motley of actors that have worked with me, who just love that place, and we owe a lot to it.
Okay, my time is up. So I'm going to, you know, you spoke fleetingly of Atul Kulkarni, you know, being a former detective and still doing jasusi, but he's never done anything like this. I mean, You talk about you doing comedy. I have never seen Atul, you know, doing the kind of, sometimes even slapstick comedy, for all the serious parts and the national awards and things like that. And that must have been wonderful also, because he plays your dad, you know, to see him perform there.
He's so prepared. He's, I think, one of the most, for me, he was a very big, I think I've learned the most from Atul. Okay, so he would come on reading day. He would come prepared with the entire episode. Like, the whole episode he knew. It was so, like, he's so rehearsed, you know. He's so on point.
Pro.
He's really something, like, to learn from. Like, for young actors to watch somebody like Atul Kulkarni is a big deal, because he really does his homework and comes to set. He comes with ideas. You know, he'll be like, because then he's not stuck for, like, smaller things. He's, like, moved on to the other things. You know, he's like, can I try this? He would ask the makers, can I do this? Can I do that? And I'd be like, I would have never imagined Atul Kulkarni, I mean, doing a comic character so well. And I think he's worked very well in the show, you know. And again, I think he got very emotional on the last day, because I remember him telling Pankaj sir and Rohan and Bharatji, you know, the creators of the show, he went and told them, he's like, you know what, nobody ever offers me a comedy. I'm just so, so, so grateful to you guys that y'all thought of me for this part. And, you know, it's so easy to stereotype actors. I think, like, he really broke it for me. He was like, you know, if you're ready to try, you can do anything. As an actor, this is our job, to be able to do these kind of characters. So please feel free to throw these characters at us, and we'll surprise you.
How lovely are you, Aahana Kumra? Every conversation, you leave a little bit of yourself with the person who's interviewing. I can only speak for myself. With me. And loved Sandwiched Forever. Guys, streaming on Sony Live, please go and watch. And have yourself a safe, healthy day and period up ahead. Lots of love. Bye.
Thanks a lot, Rishi. Take care. See you.